Hello, you're watching Hoops High, and we're here at the IHSA 3A Regional Championship between North Lawndale College Prep and Wayton-Putnam College Prep. Stay tuned for more action later.
Welcome to Hoops High, Chicago's leader in youth-produced sports broadcasting and youth media education. Hoops High is produced by high school students learning the skills of professional broadcasting. Hoops High is the flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is made possible in partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools, and Chicago Access Network Television.
The game versus North Lawndale versus Walter Payton at 1313 South Sacramento tonight. My name is Alizea, and I will be your color commentator.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The game is the North Lawndale College Prep. Welcomes you to this, the 2018 IHSA Boys Varsity Basketball Regional Final. Today's matchup will feature the Grizzlies of Walter Payton High School against the Phoenix of North Lawndale. And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that the audience please rise in observance of our national anthem. Introducing the starting lineup for the Grizzlies of Walter Payton. At guard number 15, Ryan Trotter. At guard number 21, Vince Scalise. At And guard number 30, Eric Hanneberg. At forward, number 42, Charlie Pillsbury. And also playing forward, number 35, Jamari Chaffee. The head coach of the Grizzlies is Quinn Patterson. He is assisted by Bill Gary, Rob Logan, Omni Smith, and Lewis Wu. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineup for the Phoenix of North Lawndale. At guard number 3, Daquan Tucker. At guard number 5, Jalen Thorpe. The man in the middle, number 20, Marquise Becton. At forward, number 23, Rashawn Hill. And at guard number 0, Demetrius Douglas. The head coach of the Phoenix is Lewis Thorpe. He is assisted by Carlos Tolliver, Reginald Hill, Randy Stonewall, and Terrence Redman.
Of the ball and they win the tip off.
On the line.
The ball is out of bounds.
Phoenix basketball.
You are watching Hoops High. Remember, you can watch Hoops High every Saturday at 8 p.m. on KNTV, time of night game for all the hottest high school sports action around.
And Walter Payton takes the ball back down court, goes up for a free court shot, and it is no good.
Grizzlies basketball.
We have number 30, Eric Holborn, with possession of the ball, and passes to number 15, Ryan Trouter. Good ball movement from Walter Payton as they tries to take it to the hole. But North Lawndale has good defense. And the first shot made by 42, Charlie Pillsbury. And North Lawndale gains control of the ball and takes the ball down the court. Number 23, Rashawn Hill, with the ball, passes to Demetrius, who passes to Jalen. Jalen goes up, and it is no good.
All told against number 35, Jamari Chaffee. And the line for the Phoenix is Jalen Thorpe. Two shots.
At the line is Jalen Thorpe. He goes up for the first shot, and it is off. He goes up for the second shot, and it is good. And Jalen Short scores the first shot for the Phoenix today. Walter Payton gains back control of the game. And the ball is out.
Grizzlies basketball.
And the clock is 6 minutes. Did it. North Lawndale gains control of the ball and takes the ball down the court. Rashawn Hill goes up for a three, and it is off. Daquan gains control of the ball, passes Demetrius. Demetrius goes up for a two, and it is good.
You are watching Hoops Hang. We are at 13-13. We have Walter Payton playing North Lawndale. The score is now 3-2.
We have a nice block from Marquise Becton. Jalen takes the ball to the hole, and it is good. Jalen with the ball.
Daquan.
And Daquan goes in, and it is good. And he scores his first points of the day. Walter Payton with control of the ball, trying to take it down, but it's locked up by two North Lawndale players, but manages to come out and pass to a teammate.
No basket. Grizzlies basketball. Ball thrown against number 20, Marquise Becton. First team foul. Grizzlies basketball.
No.
Who's hat is produced by high school students who are learning the skills of professional broadcasting. All of the camera work, announcing, directing, and engineering is done by students.
And another block from Marquise Becton. He blocks and also saves the ball from going out of bounds. We got Demetrius trying to go up for a two, and it is unsuccessful. And Walter Payton gains back control of the ball, trying to take it down to the down, but once again is blocked by North Lawndale's defense. Number 15, Ryan Childer for a layup. Daquan Tucker goes up for a two, and it is good. And we got some good movement.
Timeout.
And a timeout called by Walter Payton.
This is a full timeout with the Correction, this is a 30-second timeout with the score.
9-7, North Lawndale. From a timeout, and the ball is already out of bounds.
Ball called against number 3, Daquan Tucker.
And a foul is called against number 3, Daquan Tucker.
Second team foul, Grizzlies basketball. Ball called against number 5, Jalen Thorpe. Third team ball. Grizzlies basketball.
I want to pay him with the ball.
Ryan Trotter.
Devontae goes off for a 3 and it is out. Isaiah goes off for a 3 and it is out. Marquise goes up for a 3, and it is good.
Erskine. Marquise Erskine.
And a rebound by Isaiah Thomas. Takes it down court. David goes up for a 3, and it is out.
Ball's
and the
out.
Ball is out of bounds.
Phoenix basketball.
In the first quarter, North Lawndale's in the lead now, and a nice first quarter, good defense from North Lawndale, and a bit of a challenge from Walter Payton in today's game. North Lawndale and another 3, which takes North Lawndale up to 15-7. Montaigne goes up for a 3 and it is no good. And that is the end of the first quarter. 15-7. Phoenix game.
Phoenix 15. Grizzlies 7. Once again, this is the 2018 IHSA Boys Varsity Basketball Regional Final. hosted here at North Lawndale College Prep.
Go to www.freespiritmedia.org and click Hoops High tab to see the games from the past and other media projects the Hoops High crew has done. We are back with the second quarter.
Grizzlies basketball.
And we have Walter Payton with possession of the ball. And a nice steal from Dante Smith, and he takes the ball down court, and it is blocked by number 21 from Walter Payton. His name is Daniel Oslett.
Vince Scalise.
Vince Scalise.
At the line for the Phoenix is David Forrest. Two shots.
David is at the line from North Lawndale. He goes up for the first shot, and it is off. Second shot is good.
Basket, good.
Takes the ball down court. David goes up for three and it is off. And Walter Payton takes the ball back down the court. And a steal by Marquise Erskine goes down, up for a layup, and it is good.
Erskine.
Number 50 goes up for a three, and it is no good. And Demetrius takes the ball back down court.
Foul goal against number 50, Liam Dillon. Phoenix basketball.
Hoops High is the flagship program of Free Spirit Media and is ran in partnership with After School Matters, the Chicago Public Schools. This is a team effort all around, and we are grateful for our partners who make this possible.
Score is 20-7.
That's good.
Another basket for number 15, Ryan Trotter.
Traveling. Wonky, wonky. Grizzlies basketball.
A good ball move for Walter Payton. Number 35 goes up for three for Jabari Chippen. David goes up for a three and it is good.
Demetrius Douglas.
Sorry, my correction. Demetrius Douglas goes up for a three and it is good.
Donald Wall against number 35, Jabari Chavez. Fourth team foul. Phoenix basketball.
Keep up with the game action and Hoops High crew with Twitter. Just search Hoops High FSM and follow us.
Alto against number 35, Jabari Bay. Fifth team foul. Grizzlies basketball.
No, Blondell with good ball movement. Number 4, London Smith goes up for a three, and it is off. And Jalen tries to catch the rebound.
Alto against number 15, Ryan Trotter.
Sixth Jalen team Thorpe foul. At the line.
At the line for the Phoenix is Jalen Thorpe. Two shots.
Jalen goes up for his first free throw and it is off. And the second free throw is good.
Good.
Number 35 tries to go up for a layup and it is no good. And North Mondale steals the ball and goes back down court. Demetrius takes the three and it is good.
Demetrius Douglas. Ball goal against number 5, Jalen Thorpe. Fourth team ball. Grizzlies basketball.
And a block number 20, Marquise Beckton.
Well, called against number 23, Rashawn Hill.
Number 35, Jabari.
Ball. At the line is Jabari Chavez. Two shots.
Goes up for his first shot. And it is good.
One shot.
And the second shot is also good. Lawndale with great defense and also offense, and Walter Payton with a little drive but not getting them quite there to win tonight's game. North Lawndale has a 16 point lead on Walter Payton. And now we will throw it to our sideline reporter Cherish.
Watching hoops
High. The game is North Lawndale College Prep versus Walter Payton College Prep. The score is 30-14. These two teams both started out very aggressive. They are both two skilled, wonderful teams. Stay tuned for the second half.
Wow, I definitely gotta post this. Did you know that the Chicago Culture Center was the first central public library in Chicago? In 1897, the building was designed to impress and to prove that Chicago had grown into a sophisticated metropolis. The south side of the building displays the world's largest stained glass Tiffany Dome, 38 feet in diameter with some 30,000 pieces of glass. On the north side of the building is a 40-foot diameter dome with some 50,000 pieces of glass in an intricate Renaissance pattern designed by Healy and Millett. In 1991, the building was established as the Chicago Culture Center by the Chicago Department of Cultural Affairs. Every year, the Chicago Culture Center presents hundreds of free international, national, regional, and local artists, musicians, and performers, providing a showcase where the public can enjoy and learn about the arts. Hundreds of thousands of visitors come to the Chicago Cultural Center every year, making it one of the most visited attractions in Chicago.
Everybody could do their part. You can volunteer, you could help out with church groups, you could just see a kid or shorty on your block and you could reach out.
Teachers often observe disruptive behavior considering that they're around children for most of the day.
My personal opinion about a developmental delay would be, it could be a learning disability, things going on at home, things going on in school with the school structures, the budget cuts, everything's a delay in this city. Being aware of the delay is a major thing to know. So once you know what the issue is or possibly could be, you can go from there. Most of the issues that I deal with have been behavioral and or just like some slightly mental disorder, behavioral disorders. Some of the leading causes could be something that child was born with. It could be something that child is dealing with at home.
Some children are intentionally misbehaving. It comes as a second nature to them.
Some want that attention. Even though they're a quote-unquote good kid, they act out sometimes because they want that attention. So like my 10-year experience, I've kind of been able to pinpoint, okay, you just want some attention and you may have some real issues. being patient and caring goes a long way. That's the foundation, period.
Reporting for FSM News, I am Justin Patterson.
There is a large amount of homeless people in Chicago's population. Over the course of a year, over 100,000 individuals experience homelessness here.
Whether it's 90 degree weather in the summer or negative 10 degrees in the winter, it's really hard to survive in an outside environment with no food. This leads to the fact that there aren't enough resources for homeless people in Chicago. I talked to a Chicago resident about their thoughts on resources.
I do not think there are enough resources at all. I feel like it basically shows where we are and how we're willing to support enough people. I do feel that there are some places, but there are still not enough resources to help them as far as housing, jobs, giving them places, you know, food to eat or anything. There are not enough resources, and the resources that are available, they actually have to jump the loops to get the assistance they need.
That's a problem because about 700 homeless people die of hypothermia each year across America. Many people may stereotype all homeless people by saying that they abuse their donations by buying drugs or alcohol. But you can't assume someone's circumstances based on appearances, because what if someone truly needed your donation? Donate from your heart, not based on assumptions. This affects our society as a whole because people tend to look down on societies that aren't united. Also because being homeless cuts your lifespan. The average age that a homeless person dies is about 50 years old. Non-homeless Americans can expect to live to the age of 78. You never know what homeless people go through each day, and you never know if that could be you one day in that situation. So we all should do more work to improve homeless resources. Reporting from FSM News, this is Jaleel Armstead.
Approximately 1 million teenagers in America become pregnant each year. Teens who become pregnant choose to abort 35% of the time. 40% of minors having an abortion report date. Neither parents knew about the abortion.
To reduce abortions or even getting pregnant, teenagers should use protection. Having an abortion should be up to those who create the baby in the first place.
Others might say that abortions are the same as murder because you are taking a life, and you should have been more careful. But the decisions women make are in the best interest for herself and her body, because giving birth is a huge and mental event.
Becoming pregnant interferes with education and leaves single mothers and deadbeat fathers. The decisions that they make is the outcome of what best fits for them or her. No one should judge a woman's decision when it comes to what she wants to do with her body.
I don't know what Duke does.
question. Oh, there you go. It's gonna come back on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're now ready with the start of the third period. And the Grizzlies will have the basketball.
And welcome back to... And welcome back to the second half of Walter Payton versus North Lawndale in the regional finals. A recap of the first half, North Lawndale is in the lead by 16 points, and they have really good offense and defense as far as defending their basket and shooting baskets. And Walter Payton came out with a lot of drive during the first half, working hard towards winning, but it just isn't working out in their favor right now. So hopefully during the second half, they'll be able to get up and possibly win the game. But you just never know. Jabari Chipe goes up for his first free throw, and it is good. Marcellus, who do you think is going to win tonight's game?
Well, it seems to me like North Lawndale is in the lead, but it seems to me that North Lawndale has the lead, but Walter Payton has a quarter and a half to come up and come back up and win the game.
Ball called against number 21.
I agree.
Stelis. First team foul. Phoenix basketball.
Jenna goes up for a layup and it is good.
Timeout is called by the Phoenix. It's a 30-second timeout with the score. Correction, Phoenix 32, Grizzlies 15.
Ball movement from North Lawndale in the second half. The ball is
out.
I think Walter Payton has a good defense, but they need to make it better on the offense.
I agree with you. I feel like they are trying to work hard, but maybe they're working a little too hard to like with their defense and stuff, and a little bit too energized for North Lawndale. And you know, I feel like they need to go about a different strategy to beat North Lawndale.
I agree.
Ball called against number 15, Ryan Trotter. Second team foul. At the line for the Phoenix.
Jalen Thorpe is at the line.
Two shots.
He goes up his first shot and it is off. And the second shot is good.
Shot is good. number 30, Eric Hanover. Third team foul, Phoenix basketball.
And it is out.
Almost out.
You setting them up for failure anyway.
The PSAs, dramas, and documentaries that you see between breaks on Hoops High are produced by Free Spirit Media students at North Lawndale College Preparatory High School, the Gary Corner Youth Center, and Powerhouse High. We hope that you enjoy the story and message.
Demetrius goes up for three, and it is good.
People are sharing.
Demetrius Douglas.
Oh, good hustle.
Basket number five, Jabari Sembe. Timeout called by the Grizzlies.
Please check out the Free Spirit Media website at www.freespiritmedia.org to learn what Free Spirit Media is all about. Or check us out on YouTube, search Free Spirit Media to view our YouTube channel.
Phoenix basketball.
This ain't your mother. Hey, it's a miracle right now, man. So y'all play the second fight.
David goes up for a three and it is off.
Grizzlies basketball.
And it is out.
Foul called against number two, Davion Rogers. Time out, Phoenix. This is a 30-second timeout.
And North Lawndale takes possession of the ball and a rebound by Javante Brackett.
Against number 42, Charlie Pillsbury. Fourth team ball. Phoenix basketball.
Javante goes up for three, and it is good.
Basket.
What's up, bro?
Javante Brackett.
Get that steal, Javante. Get that steal, Javante. It's coming your way.
Drop it.
There you go. Let's go.
And a steal by Jabari Chipette.
Good D. Good D. At all.
And Javante saves the ball again. And North Lawndale takes the ball back down the court.
One more. Make them come out that zone.
Foul call against number 5, Freddie Martin. Fifth team foul, Phoenix basketball.
And a steal by Jabari Chipette. And he takes the ball down the court. Goes for a layup and it's blocked. And North Lawndale takes the ball back down the court.
Foul call against number 5, Freddie Martin.
Keep up with everything Hoops High and by following us on social media sites. Just search Hoops High and get locked in.
Play for one. They want to stay in the zone. We winning. Good job, Dave. Good job. Get back to him. What are you rushing for?
Lundy goes up for a three and it is no good. And Walter Payton gains control of the ball.
Take it yourself.
North Lawndale gained back possession of the ball. And David goes for a layup. The score is now 45-17.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the
end of the third quarter
with the score. Phoenix 45, Grizzlies 17. Once again, this is the 2018 IHSA Boys Varsity Basketball Regional Final.
So as we start in the fourth quarter, what make a prediction? Who you think will win this game?
Basket for number 35, Jamari Chavez.
As we start in the fourth quarter, make a prediction. Who you think will win this game?
Can you repeat the question? I think North Lawndale is gonna win. I don't really see any way possible for Walter Payton to come back from this. I mean, it is possible, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Foul call against number 35, Jamari Chaffee. 7-team foul.
And David Forrest at the free throw line.
For the Phoenix is David Forrest shooting 1-1.
Goes up for the first, and it is good. Second is also good.
Second basket is good.
And a missed three by number 23, Rowan Pugh. North Lawndale with possession of the ball again. Isaiah goes up for a three and it is off. And a turnover. Number 23 goes up for a three and it is off.
Foul call against number 15, Ryan Trotter. That's the 18th foul. Timeout called by the Phoenix. This is a full timeout with the score. Phoenix 47, Grizzlies 19.
If you just can't seem to get enough of Hoops High, friend us on Facebook, get to know the crew and what goes into every Hoops High production.
We got Zion Washington at the free throw line. Goes up for the first shot. And it is off. And a steal by David.
Control foul. Called against number 40, Connor Annalise. Phoenix basketball. Traveling. Walkie walkie. Grizzlies basketball. On the line. Foul called against number 20, Marquise Becton. Fifth team foul. Grizzlies basketball. Basket for number 42, Charlie Pillsbury.
And a nice save from Marquise Becton with the rebound.
Want to see more Hoops High, go to www.freespiritmedia.org and click the Hoops High tab to see games from the past Marty and other media projects the Hoops High crew has done.
Ladies and gentlemen, 35 in blue has been disqualified by personal fouls.
They got the
goalpost, Sal.
At the line for the Phoenix is David Forrest.
Goes up for the first shot.
First basket, good.
Second basket is no good. Point by Vince Calise. Rayon goes up for a three and it is off.
Ball's out.
We know we're not always perfect, but we are working hard and always learning. We thank you for your support and encouragement.
Lundy goes up for a three and it is off. And a rebound by Isaiah Thomas.
Phoenix basketball.
Good job, Bill Blondell.
Doing is trying to run the clock out, which is a good strategy for right now since they are up by more than 20 points. And yet another blowout coming from North Lawndale this week. They just did Little Village, and now Walter Payton. I wonder who is next on the list.
Just making an announcement that the Phoenix of North Lawndale are your 2018 regional champions. And now to make the presentation of the region championship trophy is the athletic director, Jessica Grasco.
And you're watching Hoops High. I'm here with the player of the game, David Forrest. What helped you guys come up out with this win today?
On the defensive end, just playing defense and just sticking to what we was doing on the defensive end, and the offense took care of itself.
How do you guys plan to stay on top and come out with the win in the sectional final?
Defense win games, so we just looking to get better and better on defense at night, and just hopefully, we just looking forward to every game we play. We're just taking it one game at a time.
Lastly, how does it feel to be a Phoenix?
It feels great to be a Phoenix. It's just all love. We all family, and everybody just around here showing love. So it's great being a Phoenix.
Thank you for your time. You can catch Hoops High every Saturday night at 8 p.m. on CAN TV.
Yeah,